Here's some good news. You don't have to know advanced functions and formulas straight out of a beautiful mind in order to master Google Sheets. This is your complete Google Sheets formulas tutorial. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a somewhat unhealthy amount of Google content. In today's video, I'm showing you how to use formulas and functions in Google Sheets. So let's go. So what's the difference between a Google Sheets formula and a Google Sheets function? Well, a function is a built-in operation in Google Sheets, like adding or subtracting. Pretty simple. Whereas a formula combines one or more functions to obtain a specific result. So now let's learn how to make formulas and functions in Google Sheets. Let's start with some basic math functions: adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing. To create a new function or formula, you're always going to start with the equals symbol. So let's say we want to perform the simple function of adding up a couple of cells. We'll type in the equals symbol. And now let's just click on one of the cells that we want to add. Then let's type plus and click on another cell you want to add to it, and so on. Then just hit enter and you've got your cells added up for you. So you can probably guess how to add the subtraction function in Google Sheets. We're going to enter in our equals symbol. Then we'll click on a cell and enter in the minus or subtract key. Then click the cell we want to subtract. You could also type the cell number in, by the way, but I just find clicking is easier. Then just hit enter and you've successfully subtracted. And we can of course do this same thing to multiply. So let's say we wanted to take the first week sales of this album and multiply that by 52 weeks. We'll put in our equals symbol in this cell here, then click on the sales number we want. And to multiply, you're gonna actually hit the asterisk key. And then let's type in 52 because that's what we want to multiply this cell by, and we'll hit enter. And by the way, you could have done this in either order. Like you could have put the 52 multiplied by the cell, and that's totally fine. Or of course, you could multiply multiple cells just like we did with our addition example. But let's move on to division now. We're gonna use once again that equals symbol. And let's click on the cell we want to divide, and then either click on the cell you want to divide that by or enter that cell number. So let's say this is a yearly sales and I want to divide it by 52 to see like the weekly sales. Then we'll hit enter and we've got our weekly sales number. And you can combine these functions, by the way. So if you needed to say add your sales and then subtract your expenses in one cell, of course you can do that too, and that's your formula. So it's also important to notice that if you change any of those cell numbers, the formulas you created are going to change as well, which is really the whole point, is so that you don't have to manually adjust numbers every single time. So now that we've got our basic math formulas down pat, let's learn about the sum function in Google Sheets. So just like we saw with our basic math, we could enter in our equals symbol and then click on a cell, add the plus symbol, and then click on a cell, add the plus symbol, and so on. But why spend the time to do that manually cell by cell? Instead, let's start with our equals symbol, and this time we'll type in sum. And the cool thing here is that Google Sheets will automatically make suggestions based on the data in your sheet. But let's say you don't have a suggestion or you wanna manually type this in. We're gonna click on the first cell we want, then we'll either hit shift and select the last cell, or just click and drag to the last cell, and then hit enter. By the way, with your cell selected, you're always gonna be able to see your formula in the top of the sheet here. So you can adjust it here if you needed, or you could use this as a guide if you forgot how you made that cell formula or what that formula was. But you can also get a lot of details on your cells in Google Sheets with really very little effort. Here's what I mean. Let's say we select this group of numbers in this column. If we head down to the bottom right of our sheet, we're gonna have a little sum with a downward facing arrow. Let's click on that. Here we have a bunch more information. We've got the sum of those selected cells, the average, the minimum, maximum, and count. Again, this only appears when you've selected a range of cells. But how neat is this? But of course, when you use the sum function, you don't only have to be adding the sum of one column. So let's start our sum function, and this time, let's say we want to take these few values from this column. So you can see here, we've selected this cell range. But this time, let's add a comma. Then let's click on the other cell we want to add. Then we'll click on enter or return, and boom. If you notice your cell formula at the top, you can see we've got our cell range plus this cell reference. So across multiple cells, across multiple columns, it functions the same. Get it? Sorry, that was a real sheet joke. Okay, I promise I'll stop now. Let's move on to the count function. This one is super easy too. Let's say you've got hundreds of cells and you want to tally them up really quickly. You can type in the equals symbol and this time start typing the word count. You can click on count here to get that open bracket, then select your cell range, and then hit enter or return, and boom, you've got your count. Okay, up next are our simple min and max functions. So let's say you're working on a sales spreadsheet and you want to see which t-shirt sold the most and which t-shirt sold the least. Once again, as always, we're going to start with our equals symbol. Let's type min and open the parentheses there and go ahead and select all the values you want. So remember, you can click and drag or click then hit shift and select the last cell you want to get that range. Then let's close that bracket. Hit enter or return and boom. We'll now know which shirt sold the least. So max works the exact same way. We're gonna enter in our equals symbol and open bracket. Select the range, we'll close the bracket, hit enter or return to see our highest selling shirt. Other handy functions to know are your average, median, and mode. So if we want to get our average from this set of numbers, I bet you can guess what we're going to type in first. If you guess the equals symbol, ding, 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 you are correct. So equals average, we'll open the bracket, and we can select our range, or you could type it out manually. And then we're gonna close our bracket and hit enter. And then of course we can follow suit with median. So equals median. We'll select our range, hit enter or return, and then you've guessed it, we can do the same thing for mode. Now let's say you wanna combine column information into one cell. Well, you can do that too. So there are actually a couple ways to do this, but if we want these names in one column, we could type in equals, then select the cell, then we'll use the and symbol, and then click the last name cell and hit enter. Not only did it fill out my cell with the first and last name, but it's asking if I want to autofill the remaining cells the same way, which sure, why not? And if you don't get this autofill suggestion, by the way, you don't have to manually type out this formula again. You can just grab the blue box around the cell, drag it down to apply it to the other cells. But if you don't want your names all one word, like touching like this, or let's say we want the last name, comma, first name, we can do that too. So let's start again with the equals symbol. Then we'll add our bracket and then click on the last name cell, then add our and symbol. Now here, we're gonna actually add a quotation mark, then a comma because we want that in here, then a space because we want a space in this final cell. Then we're gonna add another quotation mark and another and symbol. Then let's click on the Taylor cell, that's our first name, and we're gonna close the bracket. You'll have a little preview here of what this is going to look like in your cell. So if you're happy with that, just hit enter or return. And yes, we can apply this to all the other cells as well. Now let's learn some date and countdown functions and formulas I think you're going to find really helpful. So if you put, for example, today's date into a cell, it's always going to appear as this specific date. If I open this sheet up tomorrow, it's still going to say this date rather than tomorrow's date. But what if you wanted the date to update every time you opened your sheet? Well, let's start with equals, then type in today, And this time at the end, we're just gonna use our open and close brackets together and hit enter or return. This will now ensure that the date is always updated to the current day that you open the sheet. So if I go open this sheet tomorrow, it's gonna read the 22nd of September, not the 21st. But let's say we wanna do a countdown now, and maybe I wanna count down till Halloween. So if I just add in Halloween's date in this cell, I can now use our simple subtract method to figure out the days until Halloween. So we're gonna start with equals, then we'll pick the October 31st cell, then we want to subtract, and select the today's date cell and hit enter. And would you look at that, we are closing in on Halloween. OMG, I am so excited. And side note, if you have any guesses on what I'm going to be for Halloween this year, why don't you leave those in the comments below? But moving on, if you happen to forget any of these functions or formulas, no worries, Google Sheets has you covered. With the cell selected, you can head up to Insert, then hover over Function, and whoa, baby, would you look at all the functions, with the most common functions listed at the top, of course. But there's an even quicker way to add a function in Google Sheets. With the cell selected, just click on the Functions option near the top of your sheet, and would you look at that? An entire list of every function your heart could desire. So we've got all the ones we've covered here today and more. So this is your cheat sheet right here if you ever get stuck. I've also linked to a complete Google Sheet function list in the description below. And don't fret, my lovely custodians, if you want a rundown of the best Google Sheets keyboard shortcuts, you bet your butts, I've got you covered. You can watch that video by clicking right up here or via the link in the description below. And if you want maybe a more intermediate or advanced Google Sheets tutorial where we go over if statements and VLOOKUP and the like, just let me know in the comments below. So what did you think of this Google Sheets formulas tutorial? Did you find it helpful? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google Sheets content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.